professional makeup artist, Lana Reese. Subscribe to my channel to get videos on beauty tips, transformations, and more. Get ready, you're about to watch another video here on Viva Glam Lana. Welcome to my dressing room. I know it's a whole different layout. There's a cat playing in the background, which is normal. The lighting here isn't so great for, you know, filming. Well, it's actually not great for doing makeup as well, but hey, I get by. When I am not working on a TV show, I work at a salon here in Las Vegas called Shag Me Salon. And this week, today, begins our spirit week before Halloween. And each day we have a specific theme to dress up as for work. Today is Gay Pride Day, and I have no idea what to do anymore. I originally thought I was gonna dress in drag, like the full-on gown, wig, and just have drag makeup on. But then I just said that's too much work. And I didn't know what to do, and then I said, you know, maybe I'll just be Rainbow Bright for the sake of it being rainbow, and then I'm like, no. So today, I'm gonna completely tone it down 10 notches, and I'm just going to make myself look a little more androgynous. So I just put on a little bit of moisturizer, get it all patted in there. I'm just gonna put my wig cap on now. If you don't have an androgynous face, all you have to do is make yourself look a little bit more masculine or a little bit more feminine, depending on how your face shape is. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just applying my regular foundation. Then I'm going to use a cream concealer underneath my eyes. So I'm using Studio Fix to cover my whole face. And I'm using a color that's slightly darker than my skin tone, just to kind of give myself a more wholesome face. Then you want to take a taupey blush, or you want to take something that's like a cooler brown, or a sculpting powder, or a sculpting cream, something that could give you a contour look. Nothing that has a shine. You want to avoid shine as much as possible. And what you're going to do is you're just going to contour your cheek all the way down. Now you don't want to make this heavy. You just want to make sure that when you're talking and stuff, this is starting to form. You have more of a shadow versus like creating a makeup look. My nose is kind of pointy, so I'm just going to contour that right here to make it look a little bit stubbier. And then just a little bit right here. Now comes time for the eyebrows. Obviously, I have an arch and a nice little shape. You want it to look a little bit fuller. You can have it shaped as well, but just don't make it so feminine and in trend. So what I'm doing is I'm taking lingering pencil and just kind of shaping it in. So if you can tell the difference, this one's a little bit more flat now, and this one has more of a higher plane. So just take that. Fill it in just so it starts to settle for a second. Then I'm doing a little bit of brown eyeshadow on top just so it tones the color. I'm using mascara. You want to be careful because you don't want to show that you're wearing mascara. So what I'm going to do is just take a little bit, literally like one swipe, and use a clear brow gel to just spread it out. Now, you want your lashes to be soft and defined, but you don't want them to be fuller or longer or anything like that. Unless you're really trying to play up the look, then yeah, you can just pop on mascara and then it's kind of like, what are you? But with this particular look, you could probably achieve it a little bit better with a brown mascara that has no thickening or lengthening properties in it. Like I said, my face doesn't really have that appearance, but when you start putting on the costume, it'll help it a little bit more. So for example, so the character I'm playing today is a super fun, loud, gay pride kind of character. I feel like with this hat, I look like Spritel from Speed Racer. Oh my gosh, I'm totally aging myself at this particular time, but hey. So I'm using a little bit of Hug Me and Cherish inside my lip. I'm not taking it, you know, and putting lipstick on. I'm using my finger and just blending it so that there's color there. Super cute, oh my god. So, anyway, this is what the makeup looks like after it's all said and done. I need to fix this part of the hair, look at that. Ew, that needs to be flat ironed. I could be Peter Pan, oh my goodness. Well anyway, if you did the look according to what I said, then you should look something like this. You could take this a little bit deeper if you wanted to. I might, but I kinda wanna keep it this way. It seems a little more realistic. Yeah, I'll keep it this way. And have fun with it, you know? If you have a more masculine face, you know, you wanna try to like contour like a female, you know, don't do it all the way down like this. Just contour it here, contour your nose a little bit. and then it'll start to shape that out a little bit more. So think round thoughts. I was gonna contour my eyes a little bit, but I figured, you know, leave it alone. Don't touch it. So yeah, I'm ready to go. Super cute. And I'm off for the next 2 days, so I get to miss pajama day and zombie day at work, which that sucks. But maybe I'll do a video. Maybe.